floor plan, 24 BSC, 37,999. Okay. You got an awning that covers pretty much the entire side, guys. And there are two entry points. Okay. One at the very front and one at the very back. We're going to enter right here at the front.
Lisa, I've heard worse.
I'm already liking this design, Lisa.
Yeah?
I really am.
All right.
So right when you come in, why don't you go down there?
Okay.
Okay? And look up this way.
All right.
So we came in the front door.
Mm-hmm.
Now, normally the bedrooms are in the front.
Mm-hmm.
But here, you've got this big U-shaped dinette.
That is huge.
Right? Oh, the massage is on the chair.
Okay. You did it again.
No, I didn't touch it. It was already on. I'm getting butt massage while I'm sitting here. Bow-chicka-bow-wow. All right, so that telescope's down, and that can become a bed. As you see, there's some cabinetry up above. It's not on pistons, but it's the hinges hold it up.
Very nice.
As you see where I was sitting, here is your theater chairs. It's just two theater chairs. This is either an armrest, or if it's up, it's a snuggler, right? So you can, you know, get a little close to the loved one,
mm-hmm.
right? Yeah, you're chuckling out there. You know what I'm talking about. Directly across from here is your TV. Again, the one that's installed is a little on the tiny side, but you could actually probably put a little bigger in there. We've done it before, and I'm sure we'll do it again. All right? And that is sort of flows into the kitchen area. You got like a little galley kitchen here.
Yeah, you do. And I love the extra counter space that these drawers over here give you.
Yep.
Yeah, you know I like to make those 37 ingredient meals.
I know. Well, we like Chinese food, right?
We
like
do.
To cook and make those things. And
yes.
So you chop up all the veggies. Chinese food is all about prep. You're going to spend an hour chopping up all the vegetables and about 6 seconds cooking everything.
That is very
true.
But
it all has to be ready, and you need the place to lay it all out.
Yes, 37 little dishes,
yep.
For sure. So, yeah, you do have a large single basin sink with a nice tall faucet. The shelf underneath there, I like that. We do have
come on in if you like.
Yeah, come on in. We do have some drawers here.
Yeah, four of them.
We've got a microwave over here. Then we've got a three-burner stove and an oven with a
nice.
Drawer underneath.
Big drawer.
Big
There's
drawer
your pots
underneath.
And pans drawer.
Right. And
on
behind me.
On the other side, refrigerator.
Now, we do have to close the door to
that's
get
fine.
Into the refrigerator.
What's nice is that's not going to be affected by the slide,
mm-hmm.
so you can reach that.
Oh, that's right? true.
12 volt.
Yep.
Yeah, it's not in the slide at all.
Yep.
And then you have some space over here, like a food pantry.
Yeah.
With some drawers
as well.
Things. Yeah.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Very nice.
And so, this is sort of an interesting layout.
It is, isn't it?
So the bedroom is right here.
Well, that is very interesting.
And the bed is on a slide. All right, so I want you to show. Look,
okay.
I'm having to do the shuffle to get to the other side, okay? Which is fine, there's plenty of room over here. But this is also got to be, you gotta hold this up for the slide to come in for it to have the space that it's supposed to have. Does that make sense?
Oh, yes.
Right, so if it's flat like that, it's not going. The slide's not going to close.
Interesting.
Right? So it's got to fold up, just like so.
Interesting.
All right.
Okay.
And the slide would come over it. All right. Anyway, but it's a residential queen bed.
Nice. Right?
So there is there's a little bit of cabinet here.
Right.
They're more like cubbies. There's a tiny little cabinet there.
Okay.
And two cubbies beneath for some hanging space. If you don't want to use it for hanging, there's a shelf. Okay. There is a spot for a TV in here. I just didn't talk about it. It's over there. There's a TV backer right there.
All right.
What's interesting
Did you look
is,
for power in here?
You what?
Did you look for power?
I did not.
Here for CPAP?
It's right here.
Okay. So there is power there. Okay.
What's interesting in this layout is the bathroom.
Right?
It's really long.
It is very long.
Right? It's very skinny. But it's very long, it makes up for it. So we'll start here, of course. So now, since this has, from the outside, regular stairs, not the like step above steps or solid steps, even if these steps were closed, if you're driving down the road, you could still get in here and use this toilet. I hope you all know what I'm talking about. A lot of the units that have a separate bathroom or a toilet or half bath or whatever you want to call it, that's accessible from the outside, if the steps are up, if they're the solid steps or the step above steps, you can't get to the toilet. These are regular old school RV type steps which accordion in, I'm sure you all know what I mean. So that means there's no hindrance of using this toilet if you're in, have to pull off the side of the road. Does that make sense?
Makes sense to me.
All right. So anyway, from where I'm sitting, porcelain foot flush, 6'4", plenty of leg room, plenty of width. So this is tall and fluffy approved. Dang. All right. From where I'm sitting, it'll be easier to see where Lisa is, because this is a very skinny bathroom.
It is a very skinny bathroom.
Look, you see my feet here. It's very skinny. There's your...
Yep. You've got a solid stainless sink there. We corner medicine cabinet. Underneath the sink, we do have a little bit of space there, plus all of these cubbies here. We also have a nice window in here.
All right. Mm-hmm. So then the shower is down at this end.
All right.
As I'm getting into the shower, there is a spot here. This is actually the only spot for towels.
Mm-hmm.
So you're going to have to put your towels there.
Yep.
Okay.
But that is a ton of space for towels, actually. That is a step up shower. And oh my.
I can get just the width of my fingers between me and the top. So 6'4", absolutely max. Okay?
All right.
36 by 30. Actually, I think it's a little skinnier.
I think it's a little skinnier, too.
I think it's a little skinnier.
Yeah.
I think you got your 36, but I think it might be 28.
I think you might be right. Yeah. Maybe even a little bit less.
Yeah. I'm sure it says it on the plan.
I'm sure probably
does. You got two shelves. And you got a
or armrests.
Or armrests. And place to hang your towels.
Okay? Very nice.
For drying.
Okay.
So, I like the interesting layout of this. I really do. But the lack of storage in the master for anything, really, is a big no-go for me. That is it for hanging. So, like, if this was me and Lisa, it's just not possible.
Yeah. I think if this had, more of a traditional type setting back there.
I don't know how to reconfigure it either,
but I do like the front space.
I love
space.
Walking in with this big U. That is great.
Yes, I love that.
It's just here. Yeah, this whole back area is a little funky. Does it say? No, it doesn't have the shower within there.
No.
Let's see if it gives a dimension. By the way, we're only 5,900 pounds.
Wow. 14
feet. I'm sorry, tires, 14D rated, 28.8 feet. Yeah. Anyway, it's a new floor plan. But, sometimes they're home runs, sometimes they're not.